Fred Rogers was the beloved host of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood on public television from the mid-1960s until 2001. A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood features the beloved Tom Hanks donning that iconic red cardigan. Here's everything you need to know. A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood stars Tom Hanks as Mr. Rogers, a minister, puppeteer, advocate of kindness, gentle TV host, and role model to multiple generations of Americans. As such a prominent figure who loomed large in the emotional development of millions and appeared on TV every day for decades, it makes sense that Hollywood would want to make a big-budget movie starring an Oscar-winning actor. But this just is not that movie. This isn't the Mr. Rogers story, or a biopic like the surreal Elton John biography Rocketman or the Rise of Dick Cheney story Vice. It's more about the impact of Mr. Rogers on others, particularly a jaded and cynical journalist named Lloyd Vogel, and how his interactions with the TV host warm his sometimes icy heart. However, the movie is also highly fictionalized, as Vogel is based on Tom Juneau, who wrote the 1998 Esquire article "Can You Say Hero?" that inspired the screenplay. While Fred Rogers espoused kindness and understanding in the face of an often cruel and unfeeling world, the movie about the man couldn't escape the shocking sadness that the universe can dish out. James Emswiler, an Emmy-winning sound mixer for his work on the HBO movie Bessie, took a cigarette break during the October 2018 filming of A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood in Mount Lebanon, Pennsylvania, retreating to a balcony outside of an apartment building. People in the area reported hearing a large crash and discovered Emswiler, who'd suffered a two-story fall. He was rushed to nearby hospital UPMC Mercy and was initially listed in serious condition before his condition worsened in the hours after the accident. Emswiler, who also worked on movies like The Fault in Our Stars and Marvel's The Avengers, passed away as the result of the fall at the age of 61. There's a reason why the journalist played in A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood isn't actually a real person. It's because he's a fictionalized composite of several people. Back in 2006, writer Tim Madigan published I'm Proud of You, My Friendship with Fred Rogers, a memoir of his relationship with the late children's TV host, particularly how Rogers helped Madigan reconnect with his estranged father. That became the basis for a screenplay which Big Beach Films optioned in 2013, with Little Miss Sunshine team Jonathan Dayton and Valerie Faris signing on to direct. The script bounced around Hollywood for years, with revisions to both content and title, but it retained the element of Mr. Rogers helping a writer make amends with his father, along with incorporating elements from Tom Juneau's Esquire article. While the writers worked out the details of the script, producers worked on landing the right actor to play Mr. Rogers. They pursued Tom Hanks for years, who turned down the role multiple times, according to director Marielle Heller.
"Where's Mr. Rogers?"
Peekaboo.
Wouldn't just about everybody consider themselves a huge fan of Fred Rogers, or at least his gentle PBS series? Well, Tom Hanks didn't count himself among the loyal Rogers rank and file until very recently. As a child, he preferred sillier fare than what Rogers offered.
"I think I was 11 when he first went on the air. It was just this odd black and white show with puppets with mouths that didn't move. I didn't get it."
That all changed just a couple years before he took on the gig of playing Mr. Rogers, when a friend emailed him a 1981 clip of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood in which Rogers converses with Jeffrey Erlinger, a little boy who required a wheelchair, and then sings "It's You I Like" with him.
"I'm so glad that you came today."
"Thanks."
"Thank you."
Hanks explained, "Fred is just so wonderfully gentle and present with someone who normally would make most people feel uncomfortable. It made me bawl my eyes out. It was just so amazing. It's one of the reasons why I'm in the movie." A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood is a movie about emotions. After all, it was the life's work of Fred Rogers to tell children that it was okay to feel their feelings. That emotional realism resonates from a framework of realism. The movie diligently and accurately recreates Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. The film's scenes of Rogers' show were produced in the same studio in Pittsburgh, where the real show is made for more than 30 years. Director Marielle Heller even brought in crew from the real show to stage the recreation, including the set decorator and camera operator, who used authentic cameras of yesteryear to capture Tom Hanks as Mr. Rogers. Heller told Entertainment Weekly, "We lit it with the actual lights that had lit Mr. Rogers. Everything about it feels identical in a way that's tangible." On top of recreating the actual set from the original series, A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood features many brief appearances from some of the people who made Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood such a special thing.
"Speedy delivery returns."
"Yes, good."
Sadly, Mr. Rogers himself, Fred Rogers, died at age 74 in 2003, so he does not appear in the film. But his wife of 50 years, pianist Joanne Rogers, pops up for a moment. Fred Rogers' close associate Bill Eisler, CEO of the Fred Rogers Company, has a cameo too. Longtime Mr. Rogers Neighborhood cast member David Newell, Speedy Express delivery man Mr. McFeely, also makes an appearance. In other words, most of the gang is here to help this brand new neighborhood feel like an old home. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.